Let's start off by defining an aircraft coordinate system that we'll be using throughout our study of the dynamics of atmospheric flight. And this aircraft coordinate system is a little bit different than what we've used in our study of aerodynamics. And so let's go over it now. So let's draw an aircraft here from the side view. And here's a tail. And I'm going to draw these wings without any sweep for a moment. So let's say that the wings just go out straight out the side there. The coordinate system that we're going to use has the x-axis coming straight out the nose. The y-axis is perpendicular to that, coming out the right-hand side of the aircraft, which if these wings don't have any sweep, that would be right there along the right wing. And then the z-axis, when you complete the right-hand rule, x, y, z, then z points down. Okay, so now, of course, the y-axis is not necessarily aligned with that wing. A wing can have some sweep, it can be swept back or whatnot. The y-axis is naturally going to be perpendicular to the x-axis. It's just going out the right-hand side of the aircraft there. Okay, so we've labeled these x, y, and z. And we call the forces along each of these axes. Let's talk about the forces here. So along the x-axis, we call that an axial force. And then along the y-axis, we call that a side slip. And then along the z-axis, we call that a normal force. And that can be both a force or a translation. So if the aircraft is moving along that axis, then we say it's moving in an axial direction, or it has some side slip, or is moving in the normal direction. So it can be moving. So this coordinate system is attached to the aircraft. It does not define how the aircraft is moving. The aircraft is moving relative to this coordinate system, and it can have components in the X, Y, or Z direction. Okay, so those are our forces, and those are also translational parameters, or which correspond to a velocity, an axial velocity, side slip, or normal. Now, we also we use some other letters here to denote not only things that are along these axes, but things that are about these axes. So, for example, something that moves about the x-axis here. I'll just draw this here. If you put your thumb in the direction of the x-axis and let your fingers curl around that axis, then that axis is becomes our roll axis. Okay, and about the y-axis, if you put your thumb in the direction of the y and complete or let your fingers curl around that, that's our pitch axis. And then z, if you put your thumb in the z direction and allow your fingers to curl around that axis, that is our yaw axis. So we call that roll, pitch, and yaw. Around the x-axis is roll, around the y-axis is pitch, and around the z-axis is yaw. And so these can be moments about those axes. And we're also going to have rates about those axes. So a moment or a rate. So the aircraft can be rotating about the x-axis. Then we say it has a rolling rate. Or it can be pitching about the y-axis. We can say that it has a pitching rate. Or yawing, rotating about the yaw axis. And we call that a yawing rate. Okay, so we have roll, pitch, and yaw moments, and roll, pitch, and yaw rates. And finally, what I'd like to do here is show some letters that we use that correspond to each of these. So we have X, Y, and Z. Those are our three axes. For our moments, we use the letters L, M, and N. These are not capitalized. So L, M, and N. And then, let's see, this is our axis here. L, M, and N are our moments. If we have a rate about that axis, we call that P, Q, and R. So P, Q, and R are, so P is our rolling rate, Q is our pitching rate, and R is a yawing rate. And then finally, a velocity along each one of those axes we denote as U, V, W. Okay, so these are just symbols that we're going to use in the coming sections here, talking about flight dynamics. So you'll see these symbols show up, and I just want to be clear about what they mean. One thing to notice about them is that they are all alphabetic triads. So I'll just write that down, alphabetic triads. So notice that they go in order, XYZ, LMN, PQR, UVW. So they just go right in order, and so that should help you remember which of those pertain to which axes. Okay, another thing that we're going to have to understand is control surfaces. And so let me just complete this aircraft a little bit here with a horizontal stabilizer back here. We're going to be talking about control surfaces that are used to control the aircraft about each of these axes. So the first thing that I'll label here is called an aileron, and that control surface sits out here on the wing. I'll actually put it on the swept wing over here. Those ailerons generally work in opposite directions. So if the right aileron goes down, then the left aileron goes up. Anyway, these are called ailerons. And what they're doing is controlling the lift along the wing. So by increasing the lift on one side of the wing and decreasing it on the other, they're controlling the rolling moment. Okay, so ailerons are used to control our rolling moment, which then in turn controls the rolling rate. Okay, another control surface we're going to be talking about is an elevator. So that sits back here on what's called the horizontal stabilizer. This is the wing that's horizontal back there near on the tail. So this is called an elevator. And again, each of these control surfaces are just a region of the wing that's going to deflect. Okay, it's from the side. If we were to look at the airfoil, we'd see that a portion of that airfoil is allowed to deflect. Okay, so by some distance delta. We usually use delta and then subscript it with E for elevator or A for aileron. And then we're also going to talk about a rudder up here. We'll subscript that with an R. Okay, so the elevator, though, getting back to that, the elevator controls our pitching moment and rate. Okay, so that plugs in right here. Pitching moment, M, and pitching rate, Q, is associated with our elevator deflection. And then finally, rudder right here, which is attached to the vertical surface back there, the vertical stabilizer, that deflects to control the yawing moment and yawing rate. Now, there is some coupling. You know, when I deflect my rudder, I'll also get some rolling moment. And same with ailerons. When I deflect those, I'll also get some yawing moment. But these are the control surfaces that are dominant for each of these axes. Okay, so there is some cross coupling in how they affect other axes, but in general they dominate these particular axes. Now, another control surface that I want to point out quickly, but that we won't be discussing much, is called a flap, and these flaps actually sit inboard on the main wing here. See, the ailerons sit outboard because that increases their moment about the x-axis. What we're trying to do is roll the aircraft, and so you want that control surface to sit as far out on that wing as possible to create or to control the rolling moment and rolling rate. Well, the flaps sit inboard, and those usually work in tandem. So where the ailerons deflect anti-symmetrically, or asymmetrically, usually flaps deflect symmetrically. So if the right flap goes down, the left flap also goes down. And those are basically used to increase lift during takeoff and landing. And we'll talk about those in more detail at another point. But when we're talking about the dynamics of the aircraft, Up and away, you know, in normal flight scenarios, we usually don't use the flaps very often. And so our dynamics are going to be dominated by these other control surfaces, the ailerons, elevator, and rudder.